Talking about the 2020 Milwaukee Brewers. And Ronnie, if I'm going to ask you for one name who you think might make a difference on either side of the scorecard for the Brewers this year, who's that going to be?
Well, I think it's going to be Corey Knebel. And the reason being is last year he blew out his elbow in spring training. He thought that he was not going to be able to come back. But now with the pandemic and the way the season is truncated to 60 games, he's ready to go. He's thrown a couple simulated games, and he's thrown about 92, 93. Remember in 2017 when he had his best year, he was throwing 96 to 100 miles an hour with a power curveball. 2017, he struck out 126 in 78 innings, 39 saves, ERA around one, where he was about as good as any reliever in the game. And this was pre-Hader. Hader was there, mm-hmm. but he only appeared in 35 games.
Boy, and if healthy, another weapon for a bullpen that has kind of redefined how Major League bullpens are deployed. So that's a pitching name. Some changes offensively. We know that Ryan Braun can now DH with the universal DH in play. They bring switch hitter Justin Smoke in on a very club-friendly deal. If I were to ask you for a hitter that's going to make a difference, is it one of those guys?
I would go somewhere else. I'd go Keston Hira. Remember, half a season, really, as a rookie last year. And when he got called up, I remember Craig Counsell telling me he is going to hit home runs. And, boy, you could see that right away. He's got big boy power. What I mean by that is he leaves in the big part of the yard. This is the highest OPS up the middle, left center to right center. Look at the names and the company of Keston Hira. And he does it with kind of a really unique approach. He actually has two timing mechanisms in the swing. He has a toe tap, and he's got a really high leg lift, but he's always on time. These are some of the bullets he hit out to the middle of the yard, and I want you to see the different locations of the pitches. Even when the pitch is away, he's taking that out to center. Here is a guy who, I don't know how he does it, Matt, other than he's got terrific hand-eye coordination. He always seems to be on time, despite or maybe because of the mechanisms in his swing. You see him leaving easily out to the middle of the field. Most guys come up, I look for guys, can they leave not just pole side? We know everybody in the big leagues can do that, but can they leave middle and the other way? I want you to look at this here. Bottom hand is really where your strength comes from, but that's a pitch away where he gets full extension. What I'm going to show you is I'm even more impressed when he doesn't have room to extend the arms. I want you to watch how he collapses the back arm. The right arm tucks in next to the body, gets full rotation. That's a high fastball that he gets on top of. His ability to make adjustments no matter where the ball is pitched and squared up reminds me of this guy, Justin Turner. Similarities? Yeah, look at the big leg kick where they start early and can hang, gives them time to read the pitch. One difference, though, is watch Justin will take his hand, top hand off. It's more of a one-arm finish where Keston stays with a stronger top hand. Both have the high finish, Keston with the two hands and Justin with the one hand. But I see a lot of similarities by getting themselves started early and on time, and both obviously can leave any part of the yard. I'm really impressed with Keston Hira, and he's in the opening day lineup, Matt, and that's going to make a difference for this team. Yeah, I love that too. Did you see that stat late in the game with Christian Yelich? Innings 7 through 9 is a rookie, one of the best in the business.
Yep, that seems to be a prerequisite for rookie performance now. Cody Bellinger hit a bunch of homers his rookie year, 7th inning or later. Innings don't wear guys out the way they used to.